This is the second video of our course, and in this video I would like to show you how you can style your points that we have here currently on the map so that you can adapt them according to your likes and also that they probably stand out more from the background map. And we will do a bit more than we did in the live session in the course, because making them stand out, there are some tricks that are easily to implement. I haven't shown you that in the live situation. We will do that now. So at first, to style, to change the style of a vector layer, actually of any other layer, what you have to do is to right click on this layer and select properties or Eigenschaften. And then you get a lot of different properties that you can change. But what is currently most important for us is here symbology or Symbolisierung, and here we have the settings to change certain features of these symbols. The easiest way to go is to use one of these favorites here. So here are some already some proposals, what kind of structure, what kind of symbology you can use. For example, here red dot, I can click on that. This is larger than our original point and has a different color. If you are fancy for drop shadows, there's also an option here. I would not recommend that for scientific mapping, but you could use it like that, and you could also use several other symbols. For example, if we click here on the selection bar and select all symbols, we get some more. And you could also create your own symbols. We will not go into that here. That is the straightforward option. If you still don't find anything that fits your needs, you can select something as a template. For example, now I'll select this blue dot here. And now we can change specific elements. For example, I can change the color by clicking here in this color bar, and then I can select any color from the rainbow to represent my data. A nice purple always will do that. And you see that this point here still has some kind of border. We can't change that if we are in this version of the dialog, but if I click here on this einfache Markierung, I can also change the color of the line around that. For example, I can make it very dark black. Okay, I can change the width of the line, make it thicker, and again I change the color here to my favorite color, orange, and I can click on apply, and now you can see here in the background already. Well, it's probably not the world's nicest symbol, but it will work and it will stick out much more than before. One of the usual way to make points stick out is actually give them a black but a white background, a white line around them, and then a specific good visible color that is not so much represented on your background map. I choose now red, and I think this point is a bit too big here on the map, although that helps to identify these points, but I would like to have that smaller. So we reduce here the size and make it just 2, and again I reduce the width of the line to 0.4. And now I close this dialog. You can see they're coming out a bit more visible. Still not perfect, so probably I would again make the size a bit bigger to 3. And now we have our points here visible quite well. I go back to the symbology. So here you can see you can change the color of the filling, the color of the line, the style of the line, the width. If you have, for example, rectangulars, you can define if this should be rounded or straight. And if you have something like this square here, you can also make that an angle, turn it around, for example, 45 degrees, and then you can see you have now this kind of turned marking here. You can also move this point away from its actual center, which doesn't make so much sense for such simple markings, but for specific things, for example, with this arrow, you might like to have the arrow pointed directly on the place, so there you might need to move that a bit away. Okay, that should be enough for this symbology for the points. And in the next video, I would like to show you how you can add some labels to our points that we can identify what kind of feature is presented there already in the initial map.